Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Gardening with Simplicity. Hope you're doing well and staying safe. So today's video is about how to grow and to take care of your ladyfinger, okhra or bhindi plant. So before starting, just subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so whenever I'm gonna post any of the video related to my plants, you get it first. So without any delay, let's get started. So this is the result of only 45 days and here I started fruiting. My plant is very healthy right now. And I've potted this in a plastic tub and the tub has very less depth, you can see in the video, and my soil composition is such like that, 50% cocopeat, 50% garden soil, 25% vermicompost, 10% sand and 5% neem cake, because neem cake is necessary because it acts as an antimicrobial over here. It doesn't allow any fungus or any bacteria to grow over there. So it's gonna protect your plant. I have planted the plants from seeds. Firstly, you have to germinate the seeds and the process is just similar to the germination of legumes. So what you have to do, you have to just soak the seeds in water for 16 hours. After 16 hours, you have to drain all the water and you have to shift the seeds on a cotton cloth, just close it and put at a warm place. And on regular intervals of 4 to 5 hours, you have to spray water on the cloth. After one day, you can see the roots coming out of the seed coat and you have to sow the seed. In soil, such like that, the roots will face the downward direction. Avoid sowing the seed in very depth because it will not burst out. And this is the result of only 5 days. And now you can see my plants have grown very healthy and they started fruiting, and this is the result of only 45 days. So the things to keep in mind or the points to keep in mind are such like that. In the initial stages, when you sow the seed, you have to keep in mind that the basic requirements for the seed is like that. It needs water, soil and sunlight. When your plant started growing, they need sunlight because it is a summer plant. And avoid overwatering your plant and avoid using harmful chemical fertilizers. I know that they fasten up the process of fruiting, but somewhere you also know that they have some harmful effects. So the alternative you can use is that you can use organic vermicompost, or you can also use the cow dung fertilizers. And if it is not available at your place, you can also use the cow dung cakes. You have to soak in water. When they become mushy and soft, just drain away all the water. And so I personally like to use cow dung fertilizers that made from cow dung cakes, because it will provide both the water fertilizers, the liquid one, and also the soft mushy part. You can use both. So if you like the video, just give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Feel free to ask any query in the comment box below. And thank you so much for watching. Stay connected, stay tuned to see many videos ahead.